Hey everyone, welcome back to another episode of Mio's Delightful Kitchen. Today we're gonna do I don't want to say something very simple. It's not that difficult. We're gonna make some oxtail with red beans and rice. We're gonna make it the Haitian way. I have a few short clips of me cleaning the meat and boiling the beans. I have pinto beans right here, and I have the oxtail already seasoned and ready to get boiled. So we're gonna get started on making the rice and also boiling the meat so we can make our gravy. And we're gonna serve it with salad and with a regular salad with fried plantain if we have time to do so. That's not gonna be included in the video. We're just gonna show it after it's done when we get ready to serve. So we're gonna start getting on making the rice, and we're gonna turn, let me bring you guys over right here. This is our oxtail. It's already seasoned. It's been sitting for about an hour. So we're gonna start boiling it so we can cook. I can show you how I make it. Now our beans is right here. It's already cooked. I have some betterave boiling in the back. So right here, it's cooked. We don't let it overcook, so we can have, because it's gonna be cooking the rice. As you can see, I have some carrots in there to make it look really good, make our water, you know, pour ba nou belle couleur. So the water can be as yellow, I guess, brown, yeah, whatever. So we're gonna get started on the rice, and I'll be right back. Ok, kounyen l'huil nou chou pou nou fè dwi riyan. This is bacon. Sou pa gen an dwi, gen pil moun kap ban an dwi. Sou pa gen an dwi, gen nou a met yon morso bacon. Pou gen nou a met yon morso bacon, jist pou bo goun an dwi riyan nan dwi riyan. Pase sou ou pa gen problem avèk yon kouchon. Ok, pandan bacon nou ap fri, ou di nan avèk chou an. Mette pwa, kouvin. Menan pwa, bav le tomat yo, ki pote bav bel koule an, I don't want that. Mwen tirel. I remove the, e ba tomat non. I remove the carrots that I put in there to make it look good. Ok, kounya lo fin mette pwa, nou konen mwen men, once my pwa is frying, I put a little bit of salt. Don't mind my long spoon, this is my mixer spoon. But I just want, badly. I didn't want to pour too much. So I used that since that was close to me. Now, for your beans to fry, I'm gonna cover it. Remember, I never fry originally right away. I mean, I never put my A piece because I don't want it to burn. So we're gonna cover it, let it fry, so we can have the smell and the aroma that we're looking for. I'll be right back. Okay, now that our beans is frying, the only thing I put in there is salt. I didn't put anything else. Now over here we have the oxtail. It's boiling. We don't bother it, we just let it boil because we want it before I start removing some of the water to make the gravy. I'm gonna remove some of that water to make the gravy because I'm gonna make it get its color from its own oil. But hold your mule. But right here, we have our beans. One second, let me get something from here. All right, our beans frying. Good. Now that we get some of that frying, let's come over here, let's come closer, because y'all don't need to see me, do y'all? Don't mind my betterave that's boiling in the back, that's for my salad. Y'all don't need to learn how to do that. Let's put some dippies. You put your apis right in there, along with all your bell peppers, tomatoes, onion. Y'all know me with my sun-dried tomatoes. Now, at that point, once you put your apis, your blended apis, that is, now you start smelling it. The aroma is coming together very well. Now, at that point, you can put some bay lily, timalis, however you want to call it, tijosuin, you put that in there, and you start putting your spices. And here in Haiti, it's really canasan. If you use Maggi, you put a little bit of Maggi, black pepper. Remember, you season to your taste. Some garlic powder. I don't measure. I told y'all that already. Some sazon. And you stir. Let all of that get into the beans. You cover it a little bit longer before you put your coconut oil. I'll be right back. All right, that wasn't too long after. I don't want to get burned, y'all. Okay, now you hear that? It's fine, but at the same time, we don't want it to stuck under the shoulder. You see, your beans looking really good. You see? I lift it up so y'all can see. I know that's a little extra. Y'all know I don't use a whole can of coconut milk because that's my business. I don't like a lot of coconut milk. So I just put enough so I can have the flavor. Now, if your beans is looking good at this point, your rice is gonna look really good. Because one thing about red beans and rice, you want your beans, your rice to look good, to look very brownish. Et puis pour pas pâte, parce que quand tout le monde dit qu'on peut manger, mais tout le monde dit vrai qu'il pas qu'on fait du riz cola avec trois roues, c'est pas tout le monde qui qu'on fait. So we want it to look good. So give it a minute. Let our coconut milk cook. We'll be right back. All right, my beautiful people, welcome back. Let's see if it's time to add, you hear that? Very good. We make sure this is frying very well. See, this is the beauty when you then overcook your beans, because you want your beans to stay a whole as you're boiling it. So now the water from the beans, this is the water that the beans was boiling in. And this is what we put as the water for our rice. We might rinse this and put a little bit of more water since we want more rice. But this will give us enough rice. You see how much fresh water I put? A tiny bit. So our rice should have a nice color, even when I added a little bit of water. Now we're gonna put our parsley and thyme. Mm-hmm. we put our thyme and parsley, because we don't want that to maneuver too much around the stove. Not the stove, I mean, no, not low, in the water. All right, we're gonna wait for our water to come to a boil before we taste before we put our rice. We have to make sure it tastes really good. All right, welcome back. Let's open this. Let's see what this looks like. Let's open the meat first. Before I start stirring, let me remove that. This is too much thing. Okay, this is what our oxtail looks like. It looks really soft. Okay, it's not cooked all the way, but we're getting there. I think in about 15 minutes. Yes. In about 15 minutes, we'll be done. Guess what we're gonna do? This is my secret when I make my gravy. We remove some of the water so we can make our gravy, because we don't want to put fresh water when we make our gravy, and we don't use too much of the, we don't fry this. So now, even if we add a little bit more fresh water to make the sauce, this should give our gravy the taste of the original meat. Now we're gonna cover it to let it cook. Let's remove this because hubby don't eat spicy food, so we can have this spice. I use that for me. And that's it. We're gonna cover it, give it about 15 more minutes to cook. Now we're gonna taste our rice water. Okay, we gotta taste this to make sure. Are we satisfied with the taste? Let's put a little bit more garlic. Pepper, because we don't want it spicy. I'm sorry, my OCD is kicking in. I gotta make sure, because this bothers me, the little powder that fell on me in there. Okay, so we're gonna wash our rice so we can put it in there. Look how brown it is. So with our water like this, our rice should look really, really good. Okay, we're gonna wash our rice so we can put it in there. I'll be right back. All right, we're back. I washed my rice. Listen, this rice washer is life saver. Okay, now this is 5 cups. I'm gonna show you what I use as my cups to do my rice. I like when my rice is very greeny, of course, because we're not in the business of making jury pap. Et puis, c'est pas appétissant. On jury à pois rouge pour le pap. Du riz cola pois rouge, c'est du riz qui est supposé bien grainer. Okay. With this, we don't need to add more water. We are good. Na baisser le chaud. Turn our stove down a little bit. Let's move this down. Hold on. I'm gonna clean up for y'all, but let's get, I'm gonna show you what I use as my tass. This is the tass I have in my rice. That was 5 of this cup. Let's see. It doesn't say how many ounces, but on titas, didn't say how common. Okay, we put the rice back. Okay, now, remember, we didn't put nothing in here for color, nothing at all, because we didn't need it. Now over here, let's get back. Now we're gonna check on our oxtail. It's starting to dry, so nous voulons prendre un coup de dans ça. Nous can mettre un petit calpat tomate si nous voulons, mais soit un appel aussi simple que bonjour. We're not putting potatoes, we're not putting none of that. Okay, we're gonna let it dry because it's cooked. Look at it. This is how you know your oxtail is cooked. It's about to fall off the bones. Because we're gonna make the sauce and we're gonna stir it. We're gonna make it more cooler in here by using with a little bit of water and toss it. Turn it. We're gonna put a little bit of tomato paste, but really, if you look at this, if you look at the juice, we really don't need it, and we didn't add no oil at all. Whatever oil we had in it, that's what's gonna cook it. So we're gonna let it dry out a little bit more, so we can use it with this water that we removed from it, and the same oil. That's what we're gonna fry it and make it have a nice, beautiful color. So we can start mixing it. Okay, over here we added, I had to open the tomato paste because the one I had in the fridge was done. I put a little bit of tomato paste. Now we're gonna toss it and turn it. This is why we don't want our oxtail to be overcooked, because as we're doing this, it can, the crase, it's gonna fall apart. And I remember growing up, sometimes when our family is cooking, sometimes they don't even put tomato paste. I love the taste, very tasty. And we don't put no brown sugar, none of that. All of that is from its own juice and water. We didn't put no brown sugar, we didn't add anything crazy. That's why I said our food, our oxtail can be easy and complicated at the same times. As we're pouring a little bit of water, we keep tossing and turning. You see? Let me bring you guys closer so you can see what I'm talking about. You see? We let it move around. We can use some fresh water. And the reason we add in water, the reason we're adding fresh water is because we don't want to use mostly the water that came from it, because you know, when you season your meat, you put a lot of acid. You don't want your sauce to have that too much acidity. So we add a little bit of water, and we add a little bit at a time. You see? And as I add this water, I turn it. Pour qu'il prenne couleur. Pour qu'il y ait une belle couleur. Nous virer nos tunnels, because it's gonna get stuck on the bottom, and then we let it get stuck on the bottom a little bit. I don't know how to say it in English. I guess haïtien relé le fait vienne prendre couleur. Nous font petit malgré me mettre un petit pas tomate tout petit, c'est pour juste pour me ca gain petit goût pas tomate là. And you do that
until you add most of the water. You see, you add it. My mom taught me, don't just drop water in the middle of the meat when you're cooking. For whatever reason, I don't know what that does. Come say, hey, sorry, t'es bon, hein, ma frère. Ouch, be careful. Parce que la petite ville, elle a brûlé, t'en est. Pendant du riz noir sèche, tu vois. Regardez, j'ai du riz noir sèche. Mmm, smells so good. Mais coco bon pour tout faire, non, pas plus avant tout faire, mais quand c'est coconut oil, pour du riz noir bien grainé. Mais pendant ce temps, on a fait ça, bien de notre couleur. Moi, j'ai nous presque prêt, oui. Parce que depuis nous finissons faire sauce, nous. Fait bien nous prendre couleur. Parce que là, on met des viandes dans l'assiette pour paraître blanche. Pas de bagaille comme ça. Pas de bagaille comme ça. Nous ajoutons un petit de l'eau toujours, sous côté chaudière. A little bit at a time. Nous quittons, nous vivons. Les seigneurs. That, you see, the juice? You see how thick it is? This is how you get your oxtail to get thick. Now, we are about to touffer our rice. We put a little bit of coconut oil over it. We don't mess with it. We're not in the business of messing with our rice. Puisque nous avons un peu de jiri, I lift up the bottom a little bit. I lift up this bottom to make sure it doesn't get burned. We don't mess with it. And then we're gonna cook it. Okay, now we go back. We'll clean up last because when you're cooking, if your kitchen is all perfect while you're cooking, honey, you ain't doing nothing in that kitchen. This is why we don't let it overcook, because we don't want our oxtail to be gassy. We want our oxtail to stay as a whole but cook. I say, ain't nobody want no chewy oxtail, y'all. We want a fully cooked oxtail. Remember, ajoute un petit de l'eau encore. Parce que nous allons ajouter de l'eau, ça, oui. We're gonna add the water that we removed. That's why I cook it in this big chaudière, because we want it to have room to move around. So now that we added all of the fresh water, we're gonna add this water back in there. Daddy. Now, if you were using potatoes, carrots, and stuff like that, you could have added it at this point. Pour quitter des desserts chauds pour le cabaret. Même in my case, I'm not adding any of that. Tout à pour quitter tout ça, j'étais n'a pas son petit bleu là dedans. I'm not adding any of that, so we just let it boil until. So we can add our tomatoes, not tomatoes, I'm sorry, our bell pepper, onion, and all of that, because our sauce is basically finished. You want your water thick, you want it to have a good flavor, all the flavor from our oxtail is still sitting there, it's not watery, we didn't put no flour, we didn't put no brown sugar, because we're making sauce kebab a la haïtienne. I'll be right back. All right, this is our sauce. Our gravy is basically done, you guys. Tastes really good. The water, the sauce is thick, not watery. Now, this is what we do, and our gravy is done. I put another pepper so I can have the smell, because it's already boiled with pepper. I can't leave the other one. Excuse me, guys, I have construction outside my house, so. When I put my bell pepper and my onions, I basically turn off the stove. The heat will cook that, because we don't want it overcooked. Remember, we're making it the Haitian way. I didn't put no tomato, no carrots, none of that. Our sauce is basically over. Well, Medzi, let me turn off the stove. Let me cover it, because we're waiting for the rice to cook so I can show you guys the final product. All right, we're gonna check on our rice. Ooh, Oh yeah, I like that smell. Now before we mess with our rice, we're gonna get some stuff out of the way. Although we want these in our rice, honey, we don't want them in our plate. We want our rice to be as clean as possible. Even the pepper, we're gonna remove that so we can turn the rice, flip it, see how it looks on the bottom. Now we're gonna tuffe the rice again. We're gonna give it one last tuffe before we uncover it. Okay, we're gonna turn the stove a little bit higher so we can get our last tuffe before we remove it. I need that spice because I like my food spicy. I will be right back with the completely final product, I promise this time. Okay, we are finally over. I promise you didn't take long. I think I started cooking around, well, between, you know, letting the beans boil, but when I got with you guys, it wasn't too long ago. This food actually cooked pretty fast. We are basically a few hours in. This is our final product. I got some sweet plantain. I think I have two sweet plantains and one regular. I wanted to try it for you guys. This is it. This is how oxtail, you see, it's cutting. I don't even need a knife. That means our oxtail is cooked. And the rice, you don't put it here, right? I should have sit down to try, but you know, since it's not about a cooking channel, oh, turn it this way. My camera is switching all on me. The middle la va tomber, because I wanted you guys to see the details of this plate. Over here, I have salad, a la haïtienne, cresson, gain tomate, Ti Jocelyne, gen betterave, oui, sauce noire à la haïtienne, banane frite. This is all the good stuff in one plate. Now, this video was to show you guys how to make the rice, du ricola pois rouge, et ensuite oxtail the Haitian way. Now, everything is there. If you have any questions, please don't hesitate to post it under the video. All right, my son was shaking the camera too much, so I had to put it down. Anyways, remember to like, subscribe, turn on your notification box, and please share the video with your family and friends, because as much as I enjoy cooking it, your family and friends will enjoy learning how to make certain Haitian dish. In this case, we had oxtail made the Haitian way with ricola pois rouge, salad feuille, avec tomate, avec betterave bouillie et banane pesée. We had oxtail made the Haitian way, rice and beans, red beans and rice. We had fried plantain, we had boiled beets, which is very common in the Haitian population. We have lettuce with, I love my Roman hearts. That's what I like. If you don't like it, use whatever lettuce you want. And it's mixed with watercress. I love my cresson, so good. So please share. I will see you on the next video. Thank you again for being part of this. I will see you on the next video.